Future underwater cities, as distant or as science fiction. Yes, it may sound the idea of living underwater isn't so far on the radar in the present times. Actually, it seems very reasonable if we consider the present state of resources on land and their continuous exploitation. But let's keep all that bickering on hold for a little later. For now, let's try to trace how this fascination with conquering the depth of seas started to take shape and became a more possible and concrete idea. Welcome back to Thought Control, and today we are going to explore possibilities of underwater cities. This will lead us back to one of the greats in the field of oceanography, Jacques Vaz. The French oceanographer was one of the major figures who shaped his intrigue of understanding the ocean and gave it definition by forming the conch shell series of underwater habitats. These habitats allowed oceanauts to live underwater for days or even weeks at a time. With the time, conch shells improved, eventually allowing oceanauts to live six at a time and at a depth of around 300 feet below the surface. Jacques Vaz's quest laid the foundation stone for the future endeavors of underground habitation. Conch shells instigated such a craze in the late 60s that in the 70s, more than 60 such habitats were dotted across the seabed with different names. As optimistic as I might seem in the initial paragraph, underwater cities do offer more than just a number of challenges. Let's cater to the first question that comes to mind. From where do we get the oxygen to breathe? You would actually be surprised to find out that this particular issue doesn't seem to be troubling the scientists as much as the issue of finding other gases like nitrogen and helium, which would become essential after a certain depth inside water. Plants and artificial light form the oxygen inside water, but the different components of other gases that are required to maintain the body pressure at a certain depth are more difficult to produce. The depth of underwater habitat also becomes a major issue. According to scientists, building colonies more than 300 feet below the surface of the water might not be possible. Firstly, it would require building of very thick walls and would also involve lengthy period of decompression while returning to the surface. But these issues haven't had an effect on the scientists and oceanographers who are constantly striving to make better use of rest 70% of Earth for the better of civilization. To be very honest, in the foresight of an apocalyptic end of the human race, living inside heavy domes of glass in the ocean along with the aquatic animals seems more fascinating and feasible than the more privileged of the human race being sent to Mars or some other planet by rocket ships at the expense of the rest of humanity. How is it more feasible? The idea of living underwater not only interests the scientists around the world but also marine biologists. It broadens their area of study and brings to the fore the fact that scientists and scholars around the world have a better understanding of the Earth and its oceans than any new planet that they have been exploring for only a decade or two. Many suspect that more exploration of the oceans might lead to the discovery of various other resources that the Earth has stored in the depth of its reserves. Experts predict there could be an unquantifiable amount of minerals and metals that could be used to improve humanity and even help with other construction of underwater cities. But what about food? How do we get food underwater? The answer is pretty simple. No more veganism. And a perpetual treat for people who love seafood, as that would become the staple diet for most of the inhabitants. The aquanauts who are currently living underwater partially live on spear fishing and partially on canned and preserved food. Through hoses and tunnel system connected to the surface, even fresh water can be provided to the inhabitants. Thus, food too doesn't seem to be an issue of major concern. Architects in a Tokyo-based corporation named Shimizu have in fact designed a project worth $26 billion to create an underwater city that can support up to 5,000 people. Although it is mostly just a concept, the ocean spiral city would sit below sea level of the coast of Tokyo with power generated through massive turbines run by the force of waves, tides, and ocean currents. If we keep the rational on the side for a bit and look at the mere intrigue and fascination that surrounds the people with regard to underwater inhabitation, that in itself might feel the need to trigger this fantasy. As a biology professor at a Stanford University, Koblik states, There are no technological hurdles if you had the money and the need. You could do it today. The fictional underwater city of Atlantis from Plato's The Republic doesn't seem as much of a part of fictional now, does it? One can only hope that our underwater cities don't become as a symbolic of hubris of humans as a Plato intended the Atlantis to be. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any feedback, please let us know in the comment section below. And do not forget to share and subscribe. And please press the bell icon. Bye bye. Tata. Hasta la vista. Today I'm shooting alone because I'm the cameraman and I am the narrator as well. So let us know. As a biology professor at Stanford University.